So before we get into the video, I wanted to do a disclaimer. I do not want anybody to look at me different or judge me by things you might see in this video. So keep your opinions to yourself because that's not my business of what you think about me. And also, I wanted to say I do not encourage doing any type of drugs. So do not take that from this video and go do it. Enter at your own risk, and that ain't got nothing to do with me. I didn't tell you to do it. Thank you. Now roll the motherfucking clip, YouTube.
Y'all, we are in the fort. This is the outside of it. The inside looks much better than the outside, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you the inside. Here I have some pictures of me for decoration. I have a muffin, I have my teddy bear, and I have some lights in here. So if I need more light, watch this. Bam, light this mug up. We have nice soothing music. Let me fix this. I don't like how, I don't know if this is it. No. This is okay. This is good enough. All right. So here it is. Honestly, truthfully, this bread is old. It has mold on it. Don't come for me. I took it off, but this is what it looked like. Where you at? I need support. Hello? I don't know where she is, so I'm just gonna eat it because I've been waiting all day. I look crazy. This is the time, 2:31. I've been thinking that I ate a lot. Mm-hmm.
Unless you want a bite?
No.
You sure?
Yep.
Later that same evening.
Where you at?
Right here. This shit throw material.
You gotta come in through this door.
There's a door?
Yeah. Where the closet is. You gotta crawl through.
Big for this shit.
Damn, they're the same size.
So? The one person that makes it fall is me. You gotta squeeze the booty in.
Why this music though? Oh, you're recording. You are responsible for being my trip sitter.
Trip sitter, or sometimes a sober sitter or co-pilot, is the term used by recreational or spiritual drug users to describe a person who remains sober to ensure the safety of the drug user while he or she is under the influence.
So you gotta check on me. They said that this gonna open up my third eye. I did my research, y'all.
Tripping on magic mushrooms can free the mind, potentially helping relieve severe anxiety and depression.
What it tastes like? Is that water? Mm-hmm. Is that bread expired?
Mm-hmm.
How long does it take to kick in?
Trip occurs within 30 minutes of ingestion, lasting 4 to 6 hours.
30 minutes.
Damn, that is long.
This is a dead dose.
An eighth is equal to 3.5 grams, also known as the dead dose, which gives you the full experience.
That's what they call this.
A deadly dose.
It's not giving me the full experience. This actually don't taste like anything. I don't even taste the peanut butter.
Michaela, while I'm editing this, I am cringing. My stomach hurts from watching this. Shrooms is a psilocybin, naturally occurring psychedelic prodrug which has mind-altering effects similar to LSD, mescaline, and DMT. Effects may include euphoria, which is the experience or effect of pleasure or excitement and intense feelings, changes in perception, a distorted sense of time, and visual and mental hallucinations.
I'm so tired of eating this. This is so chewy and it's just irritating. I should be better by then. I'm actually so tired of eating this.
I'll finish.
Y'all remember at the beginning when she said she ain't want none?
This is already molded. The shrooms is. You put way too much peanut butter.
Nah, fuck that. I put way too much shrooms.
You don't have to hold your nose. It don't taste like anything.
I know, but it's just gonna be the texture.
Take a damn bite.
that shit. Don't you get tired of doing this?
I'm tired of this, Grandpa.
That's too damn bad. You keep digging.
Well, excuse me.
You'll thank me one day.
And my throat does not allow me to swallow big shit.
I should have did the tea.
And it was at this moment I knew I fucked up.
I just felt my spirit lift out of my body. Like I'm getting cold. To get the full experience. Definitely. Okay, so I'm done. I'll be back in 30 minutes. I'm back. My timer went off.
So as I go through these different phases, I'm going to tell y'all my emotions. So right now, the first phase, my first emotion was happiness. I kept laughing. I kept acting weird. So just keep watching. Every time I closed my eyes, I would feel like I'm falling and dozing off. And then I'd be back up and I'd feel just normal again. And then it would go in and out, in and out, in and out. At this point, you see me kind of getting overwhelmed or getting anxiety and trying to turn off the camera or attempting to turn off the camera. But then I took a break and I just sat back and tried to get myself back together so that I can continue to get footage. So right here, I'm just, as I'm laying back, I'm starting to see things turn into different colors, and I'm starting to see like the beauty of the thing that I was coloring in my coloring book, and everything just was different. When I tell y'all, music hit different.
It's just, it all sounds so beautiful. You hear every last instrument. If I was to ever do shrooms again, I would only do it just to listen to music. You ever listening to a song and your favorite part about to come on and you know you're about to kill it and you go to kill it and you don't kill it? Watch this. It's the singing anxiety for me, because girl, you can sing. Roxy, girl, you can sing. So I don't know why you playing around like you can't, girl. Just let that shit go.
I'm not hesitating, I just don't wanna rush.
Baby, can you focus on me? Yeah. Hands in the soap, my clothes is running and I keep looking at you. Stuck on your phone, now you're stuck in your zone.
A little background story. So around this time, I was in an entanglement, and that's why I kept looking down at my phone, waiting and expecting the text message from a certain person, but I would like to announce that now that person that I was in entanglement is no longer an entanglement because that's my boyfriend. I'm sorry, that was kind of ghetto. But yeah, so that's why I was sad, because you know, when you're a female and you're talking to somebody, you want them to talk to you 24/7, and you get overly attached and start catching feelings and start acting ghetto and just doing the most. So that's what I was doing. I was doing the most, but somehow doing the most seemed to got me where I wanted to be. Anyways, continue the video. It's the sad face for me.
Hopped in the car, you started rolling. Tryna be my poison like pills and potions. I'm geek, fuck, you already know.
My next phase is me being very emotional. If you know me, you know that I am an overthinker, and I tend to overthink on certain subjects, and I get in my feelings, and I start making up different scenarios in my head, and it's just not good. And that's what I was doing right here, and I kind of messed up the trip for myself because I was doing the most in my head. And yeah, so just keep watching.
Yeah.
I'm crying, but I'm happy. I can't control everything is like
all about the cash money.
I wanted to take a break and enjoy this and just be here with myself, but I keep trying to call this person. I don't want to get copyrighted, but I'm crying because I realized I don't know what this is doing to me. I'm not upset though. I'm crying because I realized that I need someone.
So right here, I decided to get a little personal. So I do not want to see any comments, or I do not want to get any comments about what I'm talking about. Either you're going to listen to it and take the information that I give you, or you're just going to listen to it and mind your business. So I was basically explaining about how I was feeling like I needed to have the person who is now, I feel like, okay, sorry, I was, okay. So the person who is now my boyfriend, at this time, I was feeling like I needed him. And I thought that that wasn't good on my end, because it's not good to need somebody, but it, to a certain extent, it's not good to need somebody. But I felt like it was just kind of crazy for me. But actually thinking about it, it wasn't crazy. This was just a scenario that I made up, because my version of needing him was, basically to want to talk to him every day. And I started to find myself like, every time I'm happy, I have to go and tell him why I'm happy and what happened. Every time that I'm sad, I had to go find him, talk to him about it. Every time that I was having a panic attack, I would have to find him and talk to him. And I felt like that was me being needy. And he never had a problem with it, of course, but I felt like that was me being needy. And the voice in my brain and all that was telling me, like, that's too much, you need to chill. But really, I guess that only happens when you kind of trust someone and you kind of, you, I don't know how to really explain it, but that's kind of what happens when you find a partner and you're comfortable with them and you just want to share information with them. So I thought that it was a bad thing, but really it was a good thing. And yeah,
I'm gonna say the person's name, but I need that person in my life and I'm crying because that's not good. That's not good at all. I hope I really don't look like a cartoon character. I wanted to take a break and enjoy this and just be here with myself. But I keep trying to call this person. And I just need to not do that because I don't need to do that.
I don't know if this is normal. I really don't know if this is normal. Like, I hear the cars so close and I'm crying. I'm actually in here crying. Life is hitting me so hard right now. I want to take a break and I want to put my phone down, but I can't. I can't do it. I can't.